morning, learners. I hope you're doing well at home. Welcome to today's mathematics activities. And today we want to learn about filling in the missing numbers using number line. If you can remember, last time we did the same thing, but last time we did it using the numbers involving addition. The question involving addition. But today we want to learn how to fill in the missing numbers using questions involving what? Subtraction. So I want us to do an example just to remind ourselves of what we learned during our last time lesson. So we are going to start by reminding ourselves. For example, 8 plus dash is equal to 12. Can you remember how we did this question? Yes. I said we start by drawing the number line. And our number line looks like what? Our number line, I said, it looks like an arrow. So let's draw it together. So this is the number line. And when we are numbering our number line, we start from number 0. So let's count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we count to the biggest number, or we can always continue. So we can continue just like that, 13. So our question is 8 plus dash is equal to 12. 8, if you add to a number, will give us what? 12. So that number is what you are going to look for. So let's mark 12. Now we can and mark 8. Then in order not to forget, you do like that, to mean that from 0 to 8 are how many steps? 8 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we are going to look from 8 to 12. How many steps are we going to skip? Let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many steps are those? 4. To mean this 8 plus 4 is equal to what? 12. So our answer is what? 4. So I hope you've reminded yourself what we learned during our last time lesson. So I've said today we want to use the number line in questions involving what? Subtraction or taking away. So our first example, 6 minus or take away dash is equal to 4. So we want to find the missing number. A number, if you take away from 6, we will remain with what? 4. So, we start by drawing our number line. And you draw a number line like that. Now you come, we count together, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is our biggest number, but you can continue. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's stop there. Now the question is, a number taken away from 6, you get what? 4. So we come and mark number 6. 6 minus dash is equal to 4. Now you come and mark 4. Then you do like that. To mean from here to here, how many steps? 1, 2, 3, 4. From 0 to 4, we skip how many steps? 4 steps. Now, when we are looking for the missing number, in the question involving subtraction, what do? We don't count forward like we did in the addition. Now we count backward. Yes, we are counting backward. So we count from 6 to 4 and see this missing number. Let's go. 1, 2. We've skipped from backward, going backward. 1, 2. So our answer is what? 2. 6, take away 2, we get what? 4. And now this is our answer. So when we were doing addition, we were counting going forward. Now because it is subtraction, we count going backward. Just to do the second example, 8 take away dash is equal to 3. We start by drawing our number line. Then we start counting from 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You can stop there. Now we count, our biggest number here is what? 8. So we come to our number line where 8 is, then we mark it. Then 8 take away a number, we are going to get what? 3. So from 0 to 3, these are 3 steps, right? Like that, so that you don't forget. So a number, if you take away from 8, you are going to remain with 3. So we take away that 3. Now we want to count from 8 to 3 and see how many steps you are going to make. So let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many steps did we make? We made 5 steps. To me, 8 take away 5 is equal to 3. Another example, 12 take away dash is equal to 8. So let's draw a number line. Like that. Then, so we start 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. We are counting to the biggest number. Now we mark our biggest number is 12. Let's mark it like that. Now 12, if you take away a number, we are going to remain with what? 8. So we come to our 8 and mark it. So we are taking away these 8. What are we going to remain with? So we count backwards to 8 and still find that missing number. So let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. So what is our answer? many steps? 1, 2, 3, 4. So do that 4 steps to mean 12. Take away 4, we get what? 8. Now the last example. Example 9, take away dash, we get 2. 9 take away dash, we get 2. So we draw a number line like that. We start counting from 0. Let's go 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. So which one is the biggest number we've been given? Is number 9. We come to our number line and mark number 9. So 9 minus dash is equal to 2. 9 minus dash is equal to 2. So you come where? To if. So from here to here is 9. Now, if we remove 2, how many are we going to remain with? So, we are removing that 2. And I say we count going backward because we have what? Subtraction. So, let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, we've skipped how many steps? 7 steps, and our answer is what? 7. 9 take away 7 is 2. Let me add you another example so that we can understand well. 13 take away dash is equal to 5. 13 take away dash is equal to 5. And I want us to do this together. Write it in your exercise book. And because I want us to count together. So let's draw our number line. We are drawing it together. Put an arrow there. Like that. Now we start counting from 0. Then let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 is our biggest number, but you can continue. 14, 15. Like that. I hope you are there with me. Now, 13 take away dash is equal to 5. We start by marking our biggest number, which is 13. Mark yours. Like that. Now, 13 take away dash is 5. So we come where 5 is. Yes, from 0 to 5. These are 5 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we've removed these 5. So we want to see how many steps from 13 going to 5 to give us the missing number. I've said when we are using the number line to 5, subtraction, what do? We count going backward. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And what is our answer? Our answer is 8. We've skipped 8 steps. 13 minus 8 is equal to 15. So I hope from where we started to where we've reached, you've understood something. And I want to give you assignment for today. Page 56. Go to your textbook, Primary Mathematics, page 56. Yes, these are the questions 1, 2, 3, 4. So I want you to do those questions so that you can know whether you've understood or you've not understood. And your mommy can help you at home. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Have a wonderful day.